All right, so now I'm in the game and I'm signed in as myself. And I will say that we can go to new and featured, and I'll see that that world here, our AI, the first night, is available. But I can also find it within the lesson library by going to computer science and seeing it in the hour of code space here. Or I can go to artificial intelligence, and it is one of those worlds here as well. So I will go ahead and select that to create. Now it's going to initiate this world template to download it. It's going to load it in. It shouldn't take too long, depending on your device, internet speed, but it should just take a few moments for you to get it set up. I'd also encourage you, if you were facilitating this with a large group of students, having them either do it together, guide them through the process as you project on the screen to show them what to do, or depending on the age level and readiness, that you can have this done ahead of time for them. I will say, in this opening cinematic, there is audio. So if you are facilitating and you have a lot of students, maybe they are using headphones individually to do this. But if you do need to adjust any game settings, like the audio here, pressing escape on our device and going to audio here, we can adjust our sound settings, that maybe that main game setting, I can bring that audio sound down if I want to. This is all up to you and your gameplay experience. So let's go ahead and begin, and I'm going to use block code. Now, as you do begin the Hour of AI, the first night, you're going to choose what your character, your player, looks like, their skin. Even if your students already have a skin that they normally play with in the game, you have to choose one of the options here. Now, this is a preview of what you're going to be doing throughout the entire gameplay. So right now, during this opening cinematic, it's going to show you what you as a character would be doing, like we talked about. You are teaching the agent what to do. It's an agentic AI. So you're going to model it, it's going to observe you, and then it's going to want to learn from you. So this whole first part is you doing it. And of course, through this entire process, we have to gather our materials, craft our tools, and now we have to craft a bed. So you need wood, you need wool, we find our sheep, and now we need to protect ourselves in our shelter. And a door is one of the most essential pieces that we end with as well. So this is, again, just a preview of what we are about to do in the Hour of AI, the first night. If you're on a keyboard and mouse device, pressing H will open up those control tips, which you'll see that moving W, A, S, and D will move you physically around. But if you move your mouse, that's moving your head in the different directions. Now, if you're on a touch device, we would then, and I'm on a surface, so if I move on a touch device, I have my joystick that lets me move forward. And as I do that, first off, I see my agent appear and we engage with it. Now, we'll go through this first phase, going through this conversation, this dialogue with our agent. And of course, you always have an immersive reader that's built in, which you can select that book and speaker to open it up to have any of this read aloud, and even change those text preferences, grammar options, and even reading preferences to have a line focus, and even translate it to over 140 different languages. But let's go ahead and continue on with our mission here. So we're going to go ahead and punch the tree. So as I get near it, I will mine the tree to collect the wood, and we'll see that our agent observes us and we carry on. Now, you are training the agent to complete these tasks, but it's an agentic AI. It's going to learn from you, and it also has its agents. So it's going to deploy its mini agents to help complete the tasks that you code it and train it to do. Now, throughout the gameplay, the vocabulary that we talked about that you would be leading and facilitating with your group, it will come back into the conversation that you have throughout the coding process. So here we are going to help classify the different kinds of wood or the different logs as wood. Crafting tools is an important part of the game. And so if I were to need to check of how to make different tools like an axe, a shovel, or a pickaxe, I can look at my recipe book and I see that I have sticks and planks organized that appear very similar to what the tool looks like. So let's do that at our crafting table. I open it up and I'm going to take the sticks and I place it in position. And if I were to take my planks here and I place, now I have shovels. But if I were to use all of my sticks there, Well, I now need to reset. And that's where we have our agent that we can interact with our agent to reset our inventory. If I used all of my resources, I can reset it. And now I can begin this phase again.
You'll notice throughout the gameplay, it's a continued loop of how your agent observes you completing a task, and then it wants to learn, and it wants to check and its understanding, verifying with you. So here in MakeCode, you're going to train the agent throughout the process, like crafting these tools, and if you're ever not sure, use that light bulb with a question mark to give you some more hints and understand what that MakeCode design needs to be.
As we complete every stage, the agent will observe us. It'll want to learn, so we train it, and it verifies its understanding so it can do it itself with who else? The mini agents, which will absolutely be a favorite of your students this year. As our agent learns from us and we train it to complete these tasks, it'll deploy those mini agents to mine coal, to mine iron, to be able to craft torches. And then, of course, in order to survive the first night, we need a bed. So we see our mini agents go and shear sheep for us as well. So as we survive and succeed throughout this world, we are training our agent, an agentic AI, to help us survive. And our agent says, are we ready? And we said, yes, it wasn't that hard. We're ready to take on tomorrow.
And at the end, we get a summary of all we learned in this world, learning about agentic AI, that it works on its own with permission and finishes tasks for people. Throughout every stage and task, we learn how important and ethical it is for humans to verify the AI's work, ensuring that we as humans make the final decision. And our agent shared how it's proactive, recognizing patterns, which is important for us to recognize and learn from too. And lastly, with the help of the mini agents, we're able to survive the first night.
Of course, learning about AI doesn't have to stop after a single hour. Go beyond that and try the AI build challenge in Minecraft. Create your own Minecraft agent. Solve a problem, whether it's within Minecraft, your school, or your community. And we have great resources ready for you to be able to use to facilitate this AI build challenge portion. And there's some ready-to-use AI agent challenges, or you can create your own. There's great steps to be able to follow across different age ranges and additional resources for you to click and access as well. So let's build a better world, one AI agent at a time. Thank you so much, and good luck surviving this year's Hour of AI, the first night.